reps, I think, yeah, away you go.
Thank you. Since the March constituency meeting, when I said that we had 44 community groups in Hoylake and Mells, we had our usual meeting and get-together, and we invited the chief exec of the council to come along, and he was told in no uncertain terms how we want the council to work more with the community groups and the volunteers. And he was very supportive of what he heard. As a result of that, I am now working with the Director of Strategy and Policy to show how the council can work with communities to the best advantage for both the council and for the community groups. The model boating lake, as you've mentioned, has been emptied. Sadly, there was a bit of a crack in the bottom and it's being sorted before it's refilled, but that's been after 9 years of hard work, wear with the tides and the children throwing stones in, etc. So hopefully it will then last for another 10 years, and we're very grateful to United Utilities Community Fund for doing that. In Hoylake, everything we do because we want the village of Hoylake and Mells to look good, be good, and to give us a good feeling. The Christmas lights, we are now being asked by villages, not only in Wirral, but across the communities of Merseyside, how we did it. And are they quite amazed when we tell them that the residents of the businesses raised £29,000 to do it. But they are prepared to do it again this year and extend it through into Mells, so it will be even better. One of our local residents, who has been in theatrical productions for some years as her bucket list, wanted to do Proms in the Park as a professional performance by international stars and do it free for the community. And that took place 10 days ago in Queen's Park. and I have to say that it was a wonderful experience for those who were there. I doubt it will happen again because it cost a lot of money, and sadly the collections didn't bring the money in, which was the point we were trying to prove. It can only be done by business or something, but the whole village enjoyed that, and as they did the Disneyland on the Sunday afternoon. I've never seen so many kids dressed in Disney uniforms parading around with Minnie and Mickey, which was absolutely wonderful. That was done, as I say, as a freebie by somebody in the village who loves the village. Hoylake in Bloom this year have entered the village in the northwest in Bloom, and if you go through the village, it is looking beautiful at the moment. We've got boats hanging round with plants in, we've got hanging baskets. We prayed last night they weren't damaged by the wind. I noticed they weren't. And all this is because the community groups in Hoylake all work together. But they are incensed by the parking charges, which will kill Hoylake and Mells, like they have killed Birkenhead, like they are going to kill our country parks. We are a tourist peninsula, and we should be supporting exercise, walks on the beaches, not turning people away. We've regenerated the area when the council stopped doing things for us because we wanted to continue with them. And we are really very annoyed. We're annoyed because the Cabinet agreed to this before the local elections. It's been advertised in the Globe that where they're going to go. And then they say, we're having consultation. When we hear what you think, we'll make a decision. Has the decision not already made? Because that's how we see it. And we think that that is wrong, that that's the way that things are going to do. We do what we can, we will continue to do what we can. We are a vibrant community and we will work with the council, but we do think that sometimes they do not listen to the residents.
And as always, I know you're always very quick to praise all the people that support and do some of this work, but I think we know, Jackie, that you're a force of nature in terms of doing that. And
very polite this evening, Mr. Green.
Well, you know, it's a public meeting, Jackie. So, yeah, you are an absolute force of nature. The work, I Personally, I have to say, over Christmas, driving into Hoylake and seeing the pink lights and the trees and everything, it was absolutely glorious. And the people that brought that together and thought that through are, you know, to be commended. I just thought it was absolutely fantastic. And I'm not surprised other people from around Greater Merseyside, etc., are asking you what you did, because it was absolutely, it was just a shame, I think. Council told you had to switch the lights off or something, which seems absolutely bizarre to me because they were so beautiful. With that said, thank you, Jackie. I think we're up to any other business, and I don't think I've been notified of any. I noticed that David was making a note of all the points you were making around the community report, so the issue around parking, I'm sure, has been captured there. I'm presuming, given what we've said about road safety and the golf resorts and so on, the next meeting, when it's held, is likely to be in the kind of West Kirby, Hoylake type area, though also it would impact at Greasby and the Greasby end as well, into that relief road. So we'll be notified the next location and the date fairly soon. So thank you very much for your attendance. And of course, I thought the question time was really good, so thank you very much, everyone. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.